plays in that corner. 21 years old, running 5 feet 7 inches tall. He weighed in at 144 pounds. With 3 victories, only 1 defeat, he represents contemporary martial arts. From Parkwell, Georgia, Brandon West. And his opponent fighting out of 25 years old, standing 5 feet 5 inches tall.
I'm not talking about
45 pounds, like, with 2 victories, 2 defeats, he represents American top team. From Lawrenceville, Georgia, Congo, Bama to Canada. Referee in charge of the action is Georgia Fighters Hall of Famer, Jeff Kennedy.
Here we go, fight number 10 on our fight card, professional MMA. Brandon Webb versus Congo Bakatukanda, professional MMA at 145 pounds, and here we go. Brandon Webb, 3-1 out of contemporary martial arts. Congo Bakatukanda, 2-2 out of American top team Gwinnett. Two of Georgia's best gyms going at it right now.
These guys, 45ers, correct?
Yes, sir.
African assassin. Ooh, hard low kick lands for Congo.
Brandon Webb coming off a decision victory over Ryan Jett. Congo coming off a submission loss to Dylan Kala, one of the best bantamweights in South Carolina, so no shame to that.
Both of these guys look to be wanting to set up those low kicks.
We've got 3 5-minute rounds, professional MMA.
Now, Congo was out for a while with an injury.
Congo switching back from orthodox to southpaw. Brandon Webb with a really hard leg kick.
Yeah, it was a lot of foot on that one, though. He's got to be careful with that. Sounds really hard, but then you end up with a broken foot halfway through the fight. Again, some mostly foot that landed on that kick. If you watch Congo's footwork, Congo stand on the outside of Webb's lead foot. That's going to run Webb right into Congo's power. See if Webb makes adjustments to start trying to beat him to the feet here. Now Congo's inside Webb's.
Congo with his hands down.
Again, sets up the low kick very nicely. Now these guys are starting to turn it up just a little bit.
This might be the first person I've ever seen put their hands down against Brandon Webb. Brandon Webb has got some serious knockout power. I'm not sure how many knockouts Congo has, but I know Brandon Webb has finished a lot of people with strikes. It might not be the best idea to put his hands down against Webb.
He's just trying to bait him in, but it's a risk, like you said. Anderson Silva, Chris Weidman, just takes a feint and a punch with intention.
And Congo's saying, bring it, son.
Yeah, I'm kind of surprised Webb's sitting back. No, oblige. And he comes forward and gets taken down. I think that's what Congo wanted. Congo tried to bait him in, make him overzealous, and he scored a good takedown, but Brandon right back up. Showing great athleticism. Bouncing up off the mat. Brandon uses a switch to get off the cage there. You can see the foot impressions from Congo's kicks on Brandon's leg there. One of the problems with being light-skinned is the stuff shows up a lot easier on us. That's why you can't score the fight by damage. Congo really landed those low kicks well, and then baits Brandon and throw it back and throws the two.
I am just blown away that Congo standing there with his hands down, kind of dictating the pace of this fight so far.
I think it's kind of flabbergasting Brandon a little bit too. I think even he's surprised. It's hard to tell. What does your opponent want? Does he want to bait you into a counter, or does he want to just keep you at bay by confusing you?
Yeah, now Congo has been around for a long time. I remember
big Superman.
I remember Congo fighting back in the Lane Collier days of Extreme Fight Night back in about 2009, 2008. His pro debut was against Kevin Smith. our former 145-pound champion, and he took him three rounds, lost by submission, but took our, you know, Kevin Smith three rounds. That shows a lot itself.
Yeah, that's a tough guy. Now he's daring Brandon to engage in the low kick. As soon as Brandon throws that low kick, Congo's going to fire that left.
Head kick just misses by Webb.
That was quite the graze there. Right off the gloves of Congo.
Webb still a pretty sought prospect. Back here in the NFC.
Beautiful counter by Congo.
Yeah,
10
Brandon
seconds left here in round one.
Brandon threw the low kick. Congo fired the two. And a beautiful
takedown. That's two takedowns for Congo.
And that's
that'll
the round.
Do it for round number one.
That's the round. Now, it'll be interesting because Congo has the confidence now. Congo knows Brandon's not trying to take him out when he's dropping his hands. He knows Brandon's rushing in with that karate blitz and he's shooting the double. Simple answers, so we'll see.
Somebody's done their homework. We go round number two underway. Brandon Webb, Congo back into Conda. Pretty back and forth first round. Congo scored two takedowns in that first.
Brandon
gave a slight edge in that first round to Congo.
That lead leg of Brandon's is getting chewed up, man.
Yeah, you can already see the welts on his left thigh.
Ah, you can see an outline of a foot.
Kick.
He's just not checking him.
Another leg kick. Congo finding a lot of success with that lead right leg kick from the southpaw position.
Well, and Brandon is a power guy. He likes that karate blitz. His stance is really low, so he's taking away his ability to react and check fast enough.
Beautiful game plan.
And then as soon as he starts trading kicks back, Congo blitzes forward with the two. That's the one thing about those really low stances where you want to get that power, you're really heavy on your legs.
Brandon Webb controlling the center of the cage for the most part. Congo shooting in on another takedown. This will make three takedowns if he gets it.
Yeah, Webb did what he wanted. Webb leap forward with the left hook. Congo changed levels for the shot.
And great takedown defense there by Brandon. Now Brandon has Congo pressed up against the fence in front of his corner, but he is now separated.
Two really athletic guys going at it here. Two guys that arguably could be at 35.
Yeah, Brandon Webb has been at 35 before. He had a couple weight cut problems at 35, which forced him to move up back up to 45.
It can be tough, man.
It can be. We've both been there.
Oh, yeah. That's what happens when you love pizza and fighting.
Another leg kick. I really wish we had CompuTat strikes on how many leg kicks he's landing.
Oh, and a head kick. Went high that time. The leg of Brandon Webb is making me uncomfortable.
That is about as pink as a steak.
Oh, it's swollen, welted, lumped up.
Cut that piece out and fry it on my grill. That's a big imprint on Brandon Webb's right leg.
Tenderizing the meat.
I'm sorry, left leg.
Hey, it's taking a lot of explosiveness out of him, too.
Congo again on the takedown and a beautiful kick counter.
Yeah. Double leg, high kick. I like it.
lead right hook just misses.
Congo getting loose again.
And again with his hands down.
Little TJ Dillashaw.
Switching up the stances, Dominic Cruz, or if you want to call it TJ Dillashaw now, or Cody Garbrandt.
And that style works great if someone can't get your timing down. But as you saw against with Garbrandt and Cruz, once somebody
another leg kick. They're adding up.
No doubt. I'm surprised that Brandon hasn't tried to switch stances.
And another kick.
You know, it could be his pride. He doesn't want Congo to think that those kicks are doing anything. Now Brandon's reaching for the kicks. Congo's going to go high. He's reaching for the kicks now. Yep, he reached again. No answer for the low kick.
The right leg. Look at that leg. Oh, my goodness.
Brandon's corner has to be screaming to check these kicks. I mean, there's no other way around it. You can't take a ton of damage to your front leg. Hey, he's starting to lose a little stability. If Congo keeps tagging his leg, it might not make it to a decision.
A nice kick just misses from Brandon.
Congo trying to get Brandon emotional, but Brandon's showing his cage time here. Oh my gosh. Things happening here. Some hard kicks. Congo kicks hard, bro. I mean, Webb kicks hard too, but my God, look at that.
Webb just can't seem to get his range down here. That's going to do it for round number two.
Brandon Webb not taking a seat in this corner. You know, a lot of fighters say that taking a seat takes more energy out of your legs to stand back up and get the blood flowing and the circulation back going. But when you're tired, bro, you look for that stool. Congo showing out tonight, and this isn't even his final form.
And here we go. Round number three underway.
Webb coming out extremely aggressive.
His corner had to have told him he needs a finish.
I mean, he has to know he needs a finish. The corner's yelling for him to go, but Congo's going to change levels and shoot. So if Brandon rushes forward too hard, he's going to get taken down. And that very well could be the round.
He needs to time that knee.
Yeah, exactly. He needs to fake the rush, time the knee, find an answer for the takedown. Well, Brandon's losing some stability in that leg. He just went to place it behind him and was unable to. That leg is going to hurt tomorrow. I want to see pictures.
Oy, oy, oy.
It's one of the worst legs I've seen ever in person.
Golly, another leg kick.
Nothing but respect for Brandon's toughness.
I mean, it's already almost black, and the fight's not even over yet.
I mean,
head kick.
It's pretty bad, bro. I don't know how he's still able to stay mobile. He's definitely lost a lot of explosiveness.
I mean, Brandon Webb is one tough mofo.
There was a low kick in there for sure. I heard it. Shin the cup.
Oh, Brandon. Let it go. Finish him. Let's go. Here we go. Back underway.
I mean, Brandon's got to go for broke. It's either knock Congo out or lose the fight.
Another leg kick.
He has no answer for the low.
Another
kick.
One. And I'm going right to go back and count these after this fight's over. Another beautiful jab by Congo. Another one. If I'm Brandon Webb, I'm switching to southpaw.
I'm doing something.
I'm going for broke.
I'm shooting fireballs, fire spirit bombs. I mean, he's got to go for it. There's no other option. If he goes to a decision, he loses either way. It's worth the risk. And he comes forward. Congo clinches.
Who's going to get this takedown here? Nobody.
The amount of sweat in the cage tonight is pretty ridiculous. Victory here tonight. Much more things involved in this fight, but the low kick's been the story of his dominance. Brandon Webb's leg is multiple colors on the spectrum. Black, blue, red, pink. There's some busted blood vessels in there for sure. I have no idea how he's able to even put pressure on that leg.
In our last three of three rounds, another man, that was maybe one of the hardest ones of the fight. God.
Yeah, Brandon's having a lot of trouble moving to his left.
My leg hurts.
Notice he pushes off to his right. In order to move to his left, he has to shift all his weight on his leg. Now he's limited to what direction he can move, making it easier for Congo. Superman and an overhand right. A scream and a low kick.
Short time left.
Now, Congo moving really well, but a lot of the footwork he's doing kind of reminds me of CJ.
I think that was more of a slip by Congo there a minute ago.
Got a lot of
10 seconds left in the fight. Congo shooting in on another takedown.
Smart. Don't risk it. Get the W.
And that's going to do it. What a fight from Brandon Webb and Congo back at Jaconda.
Unanimous decision, Congo Fight of Jaconda!